discuss the heredity news. Heredity is a term that is used where characteristics are being transferred from parents to offspring. Right? When parents transfer their characteristics to their young ones, we know that we look alike very much to our parents. Our habits are very much too like to our parents. But how? That is due to the inheritance or the procedure heredity. And what are the forms by which, what are the physical form by which parents transfer us the characteristics? These are gametes. And the gametes are like message boxes. When they fuse, the message contained inside them is also mixed. And when they transfer in the form of in offspring to form the zygote, these messages get mixed and form what inside the messages and read. Right? This message box mein jo message hota hai wo read kar liya jata hai and our whole body is formed. But what that messages, message box ke andar, yani gametes ke andar wo message kya tha? That message is genes. So genes are the unit of that inheritance, unit of heredity. Now what are genes? There is a conceptual problem most of the time in class 9 you have read about chromatin, you have read about chromosome, you have read about DNA. You are now reading about genes and also you are reading some of the time factors and alleles. Now what are these types? Let's just discuss about that first. So heredity, unit of heredity, I have already told you that is genes. Now genes are not usually present as such. They are present inside the gametes. First, let's talk about gametes. Gametes are formed in the parents, male parents and female parents. Separately, in both the body, gametes are formed and it is a part of sexual reproduction. Gametes are mostly formed in the sexual reproduction only. But what are gametes? They are cells. Gametes are nothing but are cells. Gametes are cells. Gametes are cells, but they are simple cells, only simple cell you can make it. What is so special about the gamete? These are those cells that contain half the number of copy of chromosome. So if the parent is having, for example, if the parent is having 26 chromosome, then the gamete will have half the copy of the chromosome, that is 13. Okay? Or if we are taking example of the human being, we are having overall 46 chromosomes. So in gametes, the copy will be 23. So they contain half the copy of the chromosome. So they are haploid. Half means haploid. So they are generally haploid. So original plant cell, original parent cell, germinal cell, the plant cell, they are usually diploid cells. They have double the copy of the chromosome present. जो भी एक chromosome है उसके twice present है क्योंकि एक male parent से आया है, एक copy female parent से आई है, तो वो double copy, right? लेकिन जब वो gamete form करेंगे within the body, then there will be half the copy of the chromosome, कुछ half the copy of information की होगी. Diploid cells. Diploid cells, but when they form gamete, they become haploid cells. Now, if we see in human beings, what is the number of chromosome, actual chromosome set, kitna hota? 46 ka. And if the haploid cell, what it become? 23. 46 originally, 23 in gametes. Now, so in 23 and 23, I guess from the initiation point, you get to know, starting, say, from sex determination, pehle discuss kar rahe. Then I'll go to the gene part, DNA part. Then we are going to discuss how the gene intermix, how these genes blend or not blend in Mendelian cell. So let's see to it. 23 chromosomes are present in a haploid cell, that is gamete. But what are these 23 gametes? Are they all same? If they are all same, then how we are categorized as male or female? So in a diploid set, if we see, we have all defining chromosomes. All defining chromosomes, that means all our body is defined by these chromosomes. So these chromosome set is 22. Okay, so 22 pairs are of that chromosomes. 22 pairs. 22 pairs. Yeah, directly 44 chromosomes. 44 हॉर्मोन जो है वो हमारी बाकी के बॉडी फंक्शंस को डिफाइन करते हैं, बट हाउ वी वॉक्स, हाउ वी टॉक्स, हाउ व्हाट काइंड ऑफ फूड वी ईट एंड व्हाट आर द फीचर्स, व्हाट आर द ब्रेन कैपेसिटी, दैट ऑल डिपेंड्स अपॉन दैट 44 क्रोमोसोम. What determines it is male or not male? That is the sex chromosome that is in pair X and Y here. And if the Y is not present, it will be a female. X that will be a female. So that's a determining factor. Now let's see what happens when there is a gamete formation. When there will be a gamete formation, so 22 of the chromosome will be present in the gamete. Okay, 22 out of 44, 22 are present in the gametes. Then for the other body function, and one of the sex chromosome is present in the gamete. You can see here one of the sex chromosome, either X or Y. Either one gamete is going to form X with X, or one gamete is formed with Y in males. Now what happens in female? In female, 22 are those chromosomes that are forming your other body function, and one with the X chromosome. Now if we see the other case, also the other case is same. 22 of the other body functioning chromosome, and one is the sex chromosome that is again become X. Both X's, dono X's, female are homozygote. Homo means same, uniform, right? Homo means same, hetero means different. Homo means same, uniform. So, if we see it in the male gamete, what is the male gamete? Male gamete is a sperm, so we can make it as a form of sperm so that we have to throw our specimens into the fine blood, right? These are sperm. And we can take it as ovum or egg cell, ovum or sperm. Now, what is the definition of sexual reproduction? Sexual reproduction is a mode of reproduction where male and female gamete fuse together to form zygote, to form the new young one. So they are going to fuse. If the fusion is takes place in type A cell, type A है sperm है, type B sperm, इसी तरह से type A ovum है और ये type B ovum. When the fusion is taking place in type A and type A, the resultant will be 22 plus 22 is 44 and X and X is female, so the child is female. When same happens with B, 22 plus 22, 44, and X and X, female. Again, the female child will be produced. Okay? Then, if the chromosome is with this B, right? If the sperm B is going to fertilize the egg or ovum, then 22 plus 22, 44, and X and Y. Male child is going to form, right? A male child is going to form. So that question might occur many a time that what are the chances of a human baby to become a girl or a boy, and to whom it depends. So 50% chances, because if I do the B, if I cross A sperm with A or B ovum, the female child will be formed. And if I cross B sperm with either A or B egg cell, the male child will be formed. So the 50% chances of a baby to become male or a female, it is not a biased thing. It is dependent not on women. It is not a biased thing that a male is going to form every time or a female is going to form every time. So what can be the answer? What are the chances of a sex determination in a human being to become male or a female? How it is determined? It is 50-50 ratio. It is 1:1 ratio of NCVS. So we have 50% chances, 50-50 ratio, 50% male, 50% परसेंट फीमेल जो है वो बन सकते हैं. ऑल्सो द सेक्स ऑफ अ चाइल्ड इज नॉट डिटरमाइंड बाय द होमोजाइगोट दैट आर फीमेल्स, दे ऑलवेज डिटरमाइंड बाय द हेटरोजाइगोट. एंड हेटरोजाइगोट इज मेल, मेल दैट इज गोइंग टू फॉर्म द स्पर्म, राइट? एंड आइदर इट इज गोइंग टू हैव एक्स और इट इज गोइंग टू फॉर्म वाई. सो यही है डिटरमाइनिंग फैक्टर, दैट इज अ मेल डिटरमाइनिंग फैक्टर, दैट इज अ वाई क्रोमोसोम. सो दैट इज अ सेक्स डिटरमिनेशन, हाउ द सेक्स इज डिटरमाइंड. नाउ लेट्स गो टू द पार्ट ऑफ द गैप. व्हाट इज इनसाइड द गैप? They are also having chromosomes. What are these chromosomes, first of all? So gametes, if we say the physical unit of heredity, the genital unit of heredity, the main unit of heredity is genes. Now that are present inside the gametes. Gametes contain 23 chromosomes. So what are these chromosomes? In a cell, chromosomes in a cell, in a class 9 of the diagram, what you have seen in the nucleus,
structure.
that's all about the unit of heredity and also the chromosome, chromatin and the DNA. So that's all about the first part. Second part we are going to discuss about portions on Mendel inheritance, because that is the most important part that can be asked more. So thank you.